What volume of the oxygen gas is consumed in the combustion of 125 grams of gaseous dimethyl ether CH3 2O, if both gas volumes are measured at the same temperature and pressure at which the density of dimethyl ether is 1.81 grams per liter? So the first thing you would do is to write the reaction described, right? So we take the CH3 2O, and that's gas, right, plus the oxygen gas, right, because you need the oxygen to for the combustion to occur, right? So the oxygen is yielding you, so these are two reactants, these are giving you the products, right? The product will be this, the CO2 gas plus the H2O liquid. All right, so now let's balance. As you can see, this is unbalanced at the moment, so we need to balance. So you can see that there are two carbon atoms, right? So we need to add a 2 here, because the 2 here applies to the oxygen. Now there are how many hydrogen atoms? There are 6, right? 3 times 2. So we need to put a 3 here, because there's a 2 already there. So how many oxygen atoms do we have? We have 3, and then we have 4, so that's 7. Right, so that means if we have 1 here, we need 6 here. So that means we have to have a 3, right? So 3 times 2, that's 6. Excellent. Okay, so now it's balanced. So the next thing we realize is that the density is equal to the mass over volume. Right? Because here it says that the given density is provided, right? And dimethyl ether is this, right? That's CH3 2O. Right, so mass over volume. And we're given that 1.81 grams per liter, right? We can use proportion, right? Because the density of this gas is given as 1.81 grams per liter, so that means that 125 grams will be for the certain number of liters, right? And why am I looking for the volume when it comes to 125 grams? I'm looking for the volume because we're essentially going to use the law of combining volumes to find the volume of the oxygen gas, right? Because the reason why we will need the volume, we will use the law of combining volumes, is because we're going to apply the same coefficient ratio to the oxygen and the dimethyl ether to the volumes, right? So if we find the volume with respect to the entire 125 grams of the dimethyl ether, we will use that to relate the coefficients in this reaction to find the corresponding volume of the oxygen gas, right? So we can mark this as X, because that's what we need to find. We don't have to, yeah, X grams. Okay, so now cross multiplying, you will get X is equal to 125 over 1.81, right? And that's going to give you what? That's going to give you 69.0607 73 48 liters, right? I don't know why I put grams here. This should be liters, right? Because we're looking for volume, right? So that's liters, right? Okay, so that's liters, right? So that's the volume. So now we can use this volume and apply to this volume the ratio of the coefficients with respect to these two volumes. Okay? This ratio will apply to the volumes taken by these two gases, the dimethyl ether and the oxygen, right? So the reactant ratio is 1:3. Okay, so what it means is that since we found the liters, and what did we found? What did we find? We found the liters of what? Of the dimethyl ether, right? Dimethyl ether. So I should say CH3 2O. Okay, gas. So we found that. So the ratio, the reactant ratio of CH3 2O to the oxygen is 1 to 3. So that means for every 69 liters of dimethyl ether, there will be volume taken by the oxygen 3 times that, 3 times 69. Right? So the number of liters of the oxygen gas is going to be 3 times the 69, because as you can see here, there's a 3 coefficient versus the 1 coefficient. Right? So that's going to be 69.0607-7348 times 3 liters, which gives you, and you have to round this to 3 significant figures based on these numbers. So that's going to be 207 exactly, rounded to 3 significant figures, liters of the oxygen gas. Thanks so much for watching. Hope this was helpful. See you in the next video.